Hello and welcome back to a new teaching session. My name is Eduard Sereduc and today we are addressing the issue, does God still judge the nations today through disease? Is COVID-19 the judgment of God for the world? Does God still judge the nations in the New Testament by plagues, viruses, or diseases? This is a question that lingers in the minds of many Christians and pastors during perilous times. Is God judging the nations because they went too far in their sins when they legalized abortion, homosexuality, and same-sex marriages? Does God send these diseases to make people look up to heaven and come back to Him? Many pastors try to explain it with expressions like, God did not send this disease per se, but He is somehow involved in how this disease will play in the world. Or expressions like God is ultimately in control, or God is sovereign, or God allowed this to happen to teach us something, or God has a mysterious plan through this. However, the bottom line implication and assumption is the same. God sometimes judges the nations through plagues, and that is in His sovereign will. Is that true in the New Testament? No, it is not true at all. God does not judge the nations anymore through plagues, especially after the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. God does not send plagues to force people to love Him. That would make Him a narcissistic, self-centered person who seeks glory and adoration at any cost. And He is not like that. The devil, on the other hand, is like that. God never causes pandemics so that He would get glory from them. The devil is the one causing all diseases. But God gets glory out of them when we, the Christians, rebuke and come against those diseases with healing in the name of Jesus. God does not create evil circumstances, neither He does evil to people so that later on He can get glory out of it. The only reason God has ever judged nations, especially in the Old Testament before Christ, was out of necessity because of His justice and righteousness. Because the Bible says that the wages of sin is death in Romans 6:23. And because nobody had paid yet for the sins of the nations in the Old Testament, God judged the sins of nations through different punishments and at different times. However, when Jesus Christ died on the cross 2,000 years ago, He was judged in full for the sins of the whole world, past, present, and future. The only sin for which people are condemned in the New Testament era is the sin of not believing in Jesus Christ, the sin of not accepting the payment and the judgment for their sins. The punishment and judgment for this sin is the second death, the lake of fire. The judgment for that sin is postponed until after the second coming of Jesus at the judgment from the great white throne. The Bible says that Jesus Himself, who had every right to judge and condemn the world because He was holy, He did not come into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world. And we see that in John 3:17. It says this, "For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved." Notice in the next verse that I will read in John 3:18, notice who is condemned. Those that do not believe in Him. And those are already condemned and judged and wait for their punishment at the end of times. Let's read this verse 18. "He who believes in Him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." And I want to read one more passage from 2 Thessalonians 1, verses 7 to 10, where it says this: When the Lord Jesus is revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, taking vengeance on those who do not know God and on those who do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. These shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power, when he comes in that day to be glorified in his saints and to be admired among all those who believe, because our testimony among you was believed. So this passage does not say anything about God punishing the world for sexual immorality or crimes or abortion or any individual sins for that matter. However, he will punish the world for only one sin, not accepting the gospel, the payment for their sins. So now that God judged all present sins of the world, including legalized abortion, same-sex marriages, he judged all those sins in the death of Jesus Christ, he does not judge anymore the world for their sins through plagues and diseases. That would mean double judgment. God is not the author of plagues in the New Testament. The devil is always the one sending all plagues, diseases, and sicknesses. Any pandemic, virus, or barrenness is a work of darkness. And I want to say this again, and we should stop blaming God for these things that happen in the world, because God is not the source of this. Any pandemic, virus, or barrenness is a work of darkness. The Son of Man was manifested in the world to destroy the works of darkness. We see that in 1 John 3, verse 8. Moreover, he gave Christians the same mandate to heal the sick, raise the dead, and cast out devils. That is written in Matthew 10, 8 and Luke 10, 19. Christians are supposed to come against any pandemic and destroy it in the name of Jesus. When Jesus was on earth, God anointed Jesus with the Holy Spirit and power, and he went about doing good to people and healing, listen, all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. That is written in Acts 10, verse 38. Now, as Christ is, so are we, the Christians, in this world. 1 John 4:17. During times of pandemics like this that we're living right now, we as Christians need to be 100% sure that no pandemic is the will of God for the world. Otherwise, we cannot have complete faith for healing while believing in the same time that God willed the disease. We should tell the world very strongly and openly that the devil is the author of pandemics, not God. God loves us, loves them so much, and has already provided the solution through healing in the blood of Jesus Christ. Even if they do not want to receive salvation for their sins, God will still heal anyone who comes to him for healing, because he is love. Even the world is looking for cures to viruses. How much more God wants to heal people? During these times, we should rise up in faith and be a living testimony of God's power by casting out any fear, by repelling any virus from ourselves through the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus, and heal those who are affected by any virus. We as Christians also have the responsibility and authority to rebuke any virus globally in the name of Jesus, command a stop in its spreading, and curse it to die from its roots. We have a responsibility to reign in life in this world from the spiritual realm. That is written in Romans 5, 17, and not allow the devil to do whatever he wants. God neither teaches people through disease, and I want to say that again. God does not teach people through disease. To say that God uses sickness or disease to teach people something is to say that the sickness is the Holy Spirit, or that the Holy Spirit is the spirit of infirmity. Why? Because the Bible says in John 14:26 that when the Holy Spirit comes, He will teach us all things. The Holy Spirit will teach us everything and not sickness or disease. God does not use helpers like sickness, but the helper, the Holy Spirit. Let's read this verse and we'll close this session with John by reading this passage from John 14:26. But the helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, He will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I said to you. Amen. I pray that you will, as a Christian, will not fear, no matter what the news are telling us, no matter what disease or viruses are in the world, that we will not fear, but rise up in faith and rebuke any fear, any disease, any sickness, and live free of sickness on a regular basis. I hope that this message brought peace and rest and joy to you. And I pray that God would bless you and keep you in His favor. Amen.